apoptosis literally means falling flames. It is a type of death occurring especially during viral infections and bacterial intracellular infections. The main characteristic of pyroptosis is the large number of inflammatory cells involved, whose aim seems to be that of triggering the general immune system. Pyroptosis is activated by the interferon alpha, interferon beta receptors, and by a particular toll-like receptor, the fifth, which is capable of binding flagellin, a molecule in the flagellum of some bacteria. Toll-like receptor 3 and an NOD intracytoplasmic receptor are capable of activating this type of cell death. NOD is a receptor present in the cytoplasm of most of the cells, and it is capable of identifying the components of the bacterial walls. Through these four receptors, a molecule called NLRP3 or NALP3 is activated. This basic molecule is complex with two heat shock proteins, HSP90 and SGT1. The activation of these receptors is capable of disassociating the NLP complex from its inhibitors, and NALP3 induces the activation of the inflammatory cell process. However, when remarkable potassium flows into the cell or strong radical stress, the disassociation of the two inhibitor proteins leads NALP3 to a different pathway, that is to say, pyroptosis. NALP3 is a molecule whose name derives from its domains. This represents a leucine-rich repeat that is typical of the toll-like receptors, an NACHD domain and a pyrin domain, PID. NALP3 is capable of interacting with a molecule called apoptosis-associated spec protein containing CARD, an adapter molecule having a pyrin domain interacting with an NALP3 pyrin domain, and a CARD domain that is capable of activating caspases. The first caspase to be activated is number 1, and it is activated by cleavage through CARD of ASC. The inhibitor domain removal of the caspase leads to its transformation and to its definitive active site construction. These three molecules interact with each other in a complex way. The TNLAP3 pyrin domain binds the ASC pyrin domain, and the CARD domain of ASC binds caspase 1. This complex heptamerizes and forms a very complex structure called inflammasome or pyroptosome. The role of this structure is to trigger inflammation. In fact, the role of caspase 1, once it is released by its inhibitor domain, is to cleave pro-interleukin-1-beta, form active interleukin-1-beta. Interleukin-1-beta protection is the first step of the inflammatory process, and, normally, NLP3 inflammasome has to start the inflammation. However, in case of potassium effluence or a giant radical stress, something different happens. NALP3 inflammasome doesn't stop with the interleukin-1-beta cleavage, but activates, through cleavage, gastrulin D molecule. Gastrulin D trimerizes and inserts in the membrane similarly to MLKL during necroptosis. It then forms a pore through which cytoplasm is released and active interleukin-1-beta is produced by the pyroptosome. Hence, as a result of this type of death, there is a very large amount of interleukin-1-beta, which represents one of the primary inflammatory cytokines, and therefore the number of inflammatory cells attracting is gigantic. It is believed that the role of pyroptosis is important in HIV infection. This virus seems to be capable of stimulating pyroptosis in infected lymphocytes to induce an enormous production of interleukin-1-beta and death, a phenomenon that will attract an incredibly large number of lymphocytes that the virus can easily infect by using a lure mechanism.
Thank you for watching. This video was created by School of Biomedical Sciences Agora. We hope you enjoyed it. If you're curious or have any doubt or question, please feel free to leave a comment below. If you want to find out more about us or want to support our project, click on the following link to visit our website.